SBR Forum's Inside the Lines is brought to you by Ladbrokes.
We are previewing the College Bowls here at SBR Forum Videos. I'm Peter Loshak. We're talking right now with Steve from collegefootballwinning.com, who has a great lifetime record in the College Bowl. Steve, thanks for being with us once again.
Thank you for having me once again, Peter.
All right, you're taking all the tough bowls this year. I'm interested to see what you're going to have to say about the Gator Bowl, Mississippi State, and Northwestern. Before we talk about it, tell us just briefly a little bit about Steve and collegefootballwinning.com.
Well, collegefootballwinning.com, as the name suggests, all we are concerned with is college football. So we're not, I don't want to say wasting, but we're definitely not parsing our time with the NFL. We just focus on college football 365 days of the year. We are predicated, we're founded on current season performance data. So the end of the year is always our most accurate time. We've never had a losing season against the spread. This year, in the last 7 weeks, we have only had one losing week. So far through this young bowl season, through three games, we're 3-0 against the spread, which takes our lifetime average in bowl games against the spread just above 68%. It's 68%, and that is since 2006. So we also are offering for SBR viewers, if they put in a coupon code, they want to become members with us, clients with us, they put in coupon code SBR20, they'll get 20% off. So
okay.
We hope we get some SBR viewers to join us.
That sounds great. But a warning to our viewers, don't use the coupon code Loshak, because if you enter the coupon code Loshak, you wind up actually paying 50% more than if you had just used no coupon code at all. So be very careful. SBR20 will get you 20% off. Loshak will make you pay 50% more than with no coupon code. So be very careful about that. Okay, we're going to talk right now about the Gator Bowl, Mississippi State, Northwestern. Now, Northwestern, of course, 11-1 against the spread on the year. This is one of those teams that was just covering week in and week out, and it was even one of the teams that the public started jumping on. I remember when I was talking to Brent from DSI during the year, you know, Northwestern would be like an 8-point underdog, a situation where you would expect them to be, where the public, you would expect the public normally to be betting on the favorite, but the public started coming in on Northwestern as a big underdog at the end of the year and winning. 11-1 against the spread. Mississippi State was just 6-6 against the spread. Now, though, Northwestern is just getting 2 points against an SEC team that wasn't even a bottom-of-the-barrel SEC team. So I'm wondering if, once again, they're a good bet here or if the lines have caught up or maybe even overcorrected. What do you think, Steve?
Okay, well, in terms of motivation, which is always very important when looking at bowl games, this Northwestern senior class is the winningest class in Northwestern football history. But Northwestern still has something pretty serious to play for here. They've not won a bowl game since 1949. But that doesn't mean they haven't won against the spread in bowl games. In fact, Northwestern is 3-1 against the spread in bowl games under head coach Pat Fitzgerald. Northwestern, as you said, is 11-1 against the spread this year. And you also mentioned Mississippi State is just 6-6 against the spread. And Mississippi State has lost their last 4 out of their last 5 games, both straight up and against the spread. So they're sort of skidding into this bowl game. Mississippi State only beat one team with a winning record this entire season. That was Middle Tennessee State. Mississippi State lost every time they failed to rush for at least 140 yards. Now, Northwestern only allowed 4 out of their 12 opponents to rush for 140 yards or more. In Northwestern's only loss, they were held to, that's against the spread, they were held to a season low in total yards, that's 247 total yards. Mississippi State's defense held opponents under 247 yards just twice this year. That was Kentucky and Auburn, and they're both ranked 115th and 118th, respectively, in total offense. So that's not much of a feat. Mississippi State quarterback Tyler Russell, he injured his ankle in the Egg Bowl against Ole Miss in their last regular season game. He is supposed to play, but he was walking around in a walking boot, and he wasn't participating in practice when they first started their bowl season practices. So even though he's going to play, he's a great quarterback, we are wondering just how much that time off and missing practice is going to have an effect on him. Certainly is not going to help things. Both teams have excellent turnover margins, but Tyler Russell, he himself has thrown, I believe it was 5 interceptions in the last 5 games. in a close game, if this one comes down to kicking, the Northwestern kicker has made 17 out of 18 field goals, while Mississippi State's kicker is 12 of 19. That's bad enough to be ranked 94th in the FBS. And if you're worried about that SEC versus the lowly Big Ten sort of matchup,
yes,
Northwestern already beat Vanderbilt this season, beat them by 10, and they were three-point underdogs in that game. And Northwestern held, by the way, they held Vanderbilt to fewer rushing yards than Georgia and Florida did. And we all know how great Georgia and Florida's defenses have been, especially rushing defenses. According to all of the metrics that we use in formulating our own unique power ratings here at collegefootballwinning.com, Northwestern should be the favorite in this game. The only thing we don't like about this game is that we are, as you suggested, we'd be falling on the side of the public in this one. About 63% right now as we're recording this pretty early. But about 63% of the bets are coming in on Northwestern. That's the only thing we don't like about this.
Well, but the public has been betting Northwestern all year, actually, and winning with it. So just because the public is on them in this game again doesn't necessarily mean that they're wrong. I mean, maybe they're wrong. Maybe the public is wrong overall. But the second half of this year, the public has been right with Northwestern.
Yes, I agree. And that's why we are still at this time, even though we're way out, as we are recording this, we are recommending Northwestern. And once again, take them on the money line. This is close enough that you can get rid of that juice. If it happens to get back up to Northwestern plus +3, I doubt it. But if it does, absolutely take your field goal then. But short of that, take Northwestern on the money line.
Okay, I like it. Thanks so much, Steve, from collegefootballwinning.com.